G'day everyone, and welcome to back to Eco. The episode number is variable at this point, so episode number for you at this point. Everyone is here. Say hello, Ono.
Hello, hello.
KJ48.
What's up?
Game Edged.
Hey, how you doing?
Pam.
Hey there.
And Red Pirate Duo.
Hello, Ono. Oh, I mean, hey, how's it going?
He's got jokes.
Yeah, I know, it was that bad joke. They all can't be gems.
No.
So, what are we all working on?
I just killed a bison.
I'm digging a hole down to the bottom of the planet.
Excellent.
I'm finding a way to make a prison to put you all in.
Why would you do such a thing?
It's not very nice.
That is definitely unkind.
Yep. Uncalled for.
I have to make sure I control you guys.
Why?
I'm just saying.
I don't know if that's not very nice.
I think it's very nice. I gotta be careful, man. Where's it, Pam? Pam?
Yes, what about it?
Are you okay?
Yeah.
All right, cool. They hurt you?
No.
Okay, good.
We'll be sorry when we finish building our 40-foot magnifying glass.
Yeah. Or the thing we're going to use to block out the sun.
Oh, we got some shells. How cool.
Where do you want to put them, Pam?
We could put them in with a kitchen table.
Oh, yeah.
What do you do with the shelves? It doesn't look like you can hold anything.
It doesn't look like I can drop anything. I'm going to try and drop something.
Dread had stuff on his shelves.
How the hell you do that?
Oh, on the shelves?
Yeah.
No, those just... That just
they come with
there.
It? Okay.
Yeah. It's just artistic.
Oh, is this really? I really did waste all that. Right? Yeah. We got a candle on the floor.
Yeah, I'll put more tallow in it. We can light it.
Pretty
you
sexy.
Make, you make bookshelves?
It was for a date night. That's why we had that out there.
Yes.
Well, the bookshelves will actually increase either the efficiency or decrease the speed of crafting, or increase the speed of crafting.
Oh, really?
And what? Just carpentry or just everything?
I think anything at this point. Because they're kind of modular.
Anything that's in the room. Anything that's in the room with them.
Yeah. So basically, I'm looking right now. Shelves. Basically, it reduces crafting cost by 2%. Can stack up to 2 in one building.
2 in one building, one room.
It says one building, but I've been able to put one in each room, or a set in each room. Then there's also your table and your chairs. They do something similar as well. The table here will reduce crafting time by 5%, but you can only put one in each room. And you can put 4 chairs in a room, and they reduce crafting time by 2% each.
Hmm.
That's why if you look at all my crafting rooms, you'll see 2 shelves, 4 chairs, and a table.
Does it say that somewhere in-game, or did you like find that on the forums or something?
No, if you go into the carpentry table and you mouse over the item,
cool.
It'll explain it.
So, does anybody know how the water wheel works?
No, I don't.
You put it just like the windmill, so you put it the same place, and you don't need anything else attached to it.
Well, do you need water?
You need water, yes. You need to be near a water source that's flowing, I guess.
Okay. Does it need? But it doesn't need to attach to anything?
No, it just needs to attach to the building you're working on.
So you need a building next to the water?
Yeah.
I wonder where my sugar went.
Just like my windmill, same thing. If you connect it to the building you're on, like if you're near the beach, then if you connect it to the building, therefore the building will get power. Or the room that's attached to.
Interesting. Okay. Yeah. Okay.
I gotta log out real quick, guys, because my sugar disappeared.
Your sugar?
Sugar.
Yeah, apparently the mill is a little funky.
Sugar.
What is lumber?
Honey, honey. Damn, I got a song in my head. Damn it!
Yep, I'm done.
What is lumber? Mm-hmm. Lumber is like, it's milled wood. So, like, it's probably the product of the sawmill, I would imagine.
But what is it for? Like, what does it do?
It's a building material. Like, you can make, like, a lumber roof. You can use it to build buildings out of.
What are the railing things you have for your bridge, Dredd?
That's lumber.
Okay, good. That looks good. I didn't want to make that stupid white picket fence. I was hoping for like some kind of wood, like brown looking fence. And that stuff you have is the closest I could find.
I'm on the roof again.
You're on the roof again?
Yeah, every time I log in on the roof.
Same thing.
Really?
Yeah, I think, you know what that might be? It might be an algorithm to prevent you from getting stuck. Because if you get stuck somewhere, I just got stuck in my door. If you get stuck somewhere, then essentially you, well, let me see how. Well, then you use unstuck to get to get unstuck, right? Mm-hmm. And so is it possible that it sort of does something like that? I don't know if I'm making sense, but when you log in,
if it can't resolve your depth properly, or
then it just automatically runs unstuck on you, right? This is what I'm wondering.
Yeah, and when you fall through the earth, it does the same thing.
It's just a thought. I'm not sure if it's real or true. Or
it may be not real. It may be false.
We are traveling beyond the realm of sight and sound.
Yes. I miss that show. Damn, I at least love it.
Was that Outer Limits or Twilight Zone? I don't remember.
That was Twilight Zone.
Yeah. Outer Limits was cool too, though. That was awesome.
Where do I make the sawmill?
Oh no, Sight and Sound was Outer Limits. You're right. Yeah.
Sawmill will be made in the carpentry table.
Let's see it. It said it was a module. I'm not sure what that means. Oh, yeah, it's right there. Oh, damn it, I need iron ingots. Alright, well, that's why I'm doing my mine.
So the modules just mean that they add on to an existing item, like a... Like a, what do you call it, a carpenter table or something.
Table, yeah. Right, now, because we got bookshelves in here, my mill is now showing a status of one module added.
All right, so I just placed a water wheel up at the top of the waterfall. Just, I thought it would be cool to have a water wheel. So we have a water wheel.
Thank you.
Cool.
Sorry. I tried to put the stairs down and it won't work. What's wrong with these stairs?
And right now I'm trying to clear dirt out without disturbing one of the huckleberry bushes.
I got gold here.
Is it normal that the first thing I found underground was gold?
Yes. That's what I found,
no,
too.
No, I found gold above ground.
Oh, weird. I'm looking for copper, man. Stupid gold.
Anybody have an idea how these stairs will go down properly?
You gotta put something on the side of them. That's what I had to do.
Oh, yeah. Right.
I must say, the right-click into a chest is a great feature.
Yes. I have to agree 100% with you on that.
The what?
Right clicking into a chest.
Or cart. Like if you've got something on your
anything.
Table and you right click on it, happy days. It goes into a table or storage thing.
Yeah.
Really?
And then you can left click to take the first thing out of the slot. Like the thing in the first slot will come out. Like if I've got a chest full of dirt and I left click on it, gets a unit out.
Huh. And
we should take the full 10 stacks.
If you have a chest and you have say for example a workbench or something and you want to transfer wood from the chest to the workbench or something like that, you can open the chest, grab the material, and then basically don't close the chest. But then click the background behind the chest and then go over to the workstation and then you can just open the switch between pulling stuff out of the chest and putting it into the right clicking it into the workstation. You don't even have to go back to the chest. The chest dialog stays up. It's kind of hard to explain.
There's a proximity on it, though. You can't go too far away.
Yeah.
Which is why it was poking a hole in the side of my building.
Nice.
So much faster.
Gets the job done.
All right, well, that's going to have to be like that.
Well, I don't know what I'm going to do with this water wheel, but it's in the middle of the forest generating 200 watts of power.
There you go. Yeah. Same as a windmill, so that's good to know.
Yeah.
I was curious to see what you get more of.
What I might do is this was a test just to see how to place it and how it works. But what I might do is run an aqueduct from the waterfall around to where my building is, and then put the water wheel at my building, and then use it to power something in my building. That's just one idea.
Well, that works.
Does that work?
I don't know.
Is this game built that way?
I don't know. Let's find out. That's what I want to find out.
Let's not say we did. What's
that? What are you going to build around it now?
Well, I'm going to build an aqueduct.
Oh, okay.
And I'm going to run water. That's how you do it with water wheels, right? You basically sluice the water to a location, and then you run that sluice water into the water wheel where you want it to do the actual work. You don't necessarily put the water wheel at run of the river. You can, like, that's how a lot of, like, the gold miners used to do stuff. They used to sluice water away from the river, and then they would use it to do work where they needed that energy, not at the river, but where they needed the energy to be applied. So they'd run these sluices, right?
Or an aqueduct. Shift click, damn it.
I know what you mean.
And escape to close.
Yeah. I finally got out of that habit. What did I come up here for?
Oh my god.
Oh yeah, more chests.
Gotta get the second floor up.
Let's find... Okay, this bit of land looks good. Let's see.
It's nice to stack chests.
You can stack chests on top of each other?
Yeah. Thank god.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, Maddie, no. Damn it. You hear that, Pam?
I heard it.
That's good to know.
Very good.
That's been a problem we've been having here. That's good to know.
They don't hold a lot.
No, they don't, but at least
especially when you're trying to put stone in them.
Yeah, that's a real bitch.
Well, volume does matter.
And size, too, from what I hear. And definitely science.
Obviously, we're not going to encourage you, Game Edge.
I've never had complaints, so I don't know how to respond.
We're talking about buttholes again in a minute.
Oh, God. How do you know you're filming with Game Edge? It's an anatomy lesson.
Sex ed, baby. Sex ed. Gotta do
it. I'm gonna have to click that damn 18 plus on my channel, aren't I?
Yes, you are.
Yes,
I think you are.
I figure I'd just teach them. Your parents do Bruce? Come on, listen to us play. Buttholes and all. We can do it.
Oh, I'm out of wood, guys, in the campfire. Who's collecting wood?
I have some.
I've got some wood if you'd like.
I need lumber. I need boards, rather.
There's some in the...
boards. I haven't crafted any.
Is there?
Yeah. I'll get you some out. Remember last day I said I didn't know what you want to do with them? You said just leave them there. I did.
Right.
I was going to drop these upstairs. I'll be right down.
Okay.
You see a second floor coming up?
No, I didn't see. We got a second floor going. Cool.
We do.
Cool. Yeah, just when you get a chance, if you just could stick some boards in the campfire so it would keep on cooking. I've got to head north.
All right, don't get lost.
I'll try not to.
And be careful of the brand new add-on there, the lions and stuff.
Okay.
And the snakes.
There's a snake add-on?
Snakes and scorpions.
Oh!
And Bengal tigers.
Now I get it.
I've got a bow and arrow for them.
I was concentrating, so I wasn't quite...
All of a sudden, scorpions woke him up.
I was trying to figure something out, and so.
Flashback.
I know.
When I'm digging underground and I accidentally dig out stone and I want to replace it with something, is there any kind of stone that looks kind of like the walls? Does anybody know about that?
Not really. I would just use dirt.
No, I'm not using dirt.
You're going to use dirt and that's all there is to it.
I'll bet you stone road would look fine. Look better than dirt anyway.
That's expensive.
Oh, are you kidding? I've got stone coming out of my ears.
No. Stone Road. Oh, Stone Road.
Yeah, Stone Road.
Oh, that's not bad, actually. Yeah. Just not mortared stone.
Oh, mortared stone? Bugger that. That's expensive shit.
Yeah. Oh, I know.
That's expensive shit, god damn it. Crikey. say it properly, for fuck's sake, man.
I think he did.
I want the American version.
No. We get the authentic bishop version, which is... you know, you should be happy that that there's no guns in this game, because I suspect that Bishop would be using it.
I suspect Bishop was about to use it. Yeah, I heard that little...
Yeah.
That was kind of mean there, Bish.
Not mean, appropriate.
I have feelings, too. He makes fun of us Canadians.
You don't have...
I wasn't going to shoot you.
Feelings.
Oh, just Ono? I don't blame you.
What? I didn't do anything.
I don't blame you. There we go. A new desk.
Cool.
But Fletcher's desk is up. Probably useless.
I've got to go. No, I mean, you have to have Fletcher's to make arrows, right?
Exactly it. Where Windows? God damn it. There's always something you have to make. Once it gets easier, don't forget, guys, if you're watching this, I want to explain a couple of things, because I know a lot of you have been asking me that. Yes, there's a hell of a grind. Yes, it's a really fun game. I'll be dead honest with you. If I didn't like it, I wouldn't be playing this still. It is very difficult, and there's a lot to learn. So as you're playing this game, we're a little more quiet than usual. You see me going through it. I understand a lot better. But do understand that this game will take a lot of your time to learn, and you're going to enjoy it. But it's just like, God, man, it's so much fun. You have to play it. It's expensive, yes, but it's worth
That's what everybody's saying on my channel. They'd like to get it, but it's just too much.
It's expensive, but for $40, you get four copies, right?
Oh, you have four copies?
I think
so. I didn't know that.
No. That's... maybe you do. I don't know. Because I got all my copies because of Kickstarter. I don't know. It's $40. I don't know if you get four copies or whatever.
Well,
you have
Dredd
to go,
says
you have
it.
To go and read it.
Well, Dredd said it. Yeah, and if he said it, then it's his fault. And if there's any problems, you contact Dredd. He'll send you a couple copies.
No, that's not the KJ for it guarantee. It's if you have any problems, you contact Game Edge.
Oh,
Game
nice.
Edge will go to your home and actually install it for you.
Yeah.
That's revision number two of the Cage 848 guarantee. There's been a few Cage 848 guarantees.
That's funny.
Oh my God. God help us all.
Oh, I agree.
Oh, no. Oh, corn is finally growing again, but I need Fiddlehead.
Come on, Pam, hurry up.
I'm working on it.
I'm starving over here.
No, I'm working on it.
I'm from New York. Okay, did you ever pick up that road tool I made for you?
No, not yet. Did you need me to?
No, it's here, though.
This road is pissing me off because stuff that you put down, it goes on the ground underneath the road, so it's in the road. The chest, the bottom part of my chest is in the road. The bottom of the brazier is in the road.
Oh yeah, because the road sticks up a little bit. Like the only stone ones do. The dirt ones don't, but the stone roads do.
Who wants to walk around dirt roads like a commoner?
Whoa! Who let the dogs out? There's fucking dogs in this game. I get out of here. It's Cagey's bringing them.
We've discussed this. No dogs anymore in this game. No, just kidding, Pam. What was that?
I think her dog ate her.
I think she's settling the dog.
I had to mute because of the dog. So.
Oh, okay.
I was going to say that Bish is just bringing him down to kill you all, so.
There we go. I got a nice little sign for you, Cage, outside.
Good. I like
Meet
signs.
The hounds.
Yeah, I think you're going to enjoy that. That's good.
I'm never going to get out of this goddamn mine. How long do you think if I find freaking copper?
You know what would be fun right now to actually go down there and actually like shovel shit down the mine for him? Yeah,
that wouldn't
it takes
be
a
funny.
Dig. That would be funny for me.
I don't agree with your sense of humor.
I do. The good thing is I do agree with my sense of humor.
Dogs may bark again because Firecrow made the decision to go order something to come to the door, so they will bark when it comes to the door.
Get Firecrow on, please.
Uh-oh.
You better be ordering a friggin' calzone with that because I'm friggin' starving right now.
Is that the Game Edge meal of choice?
Oh, I eat anything, man.
Calzones are good, but they're too damn messy.
As long as it's properly made, not the cheap ones, the good ones.
Like I love calzone.
A real Italian calzone, you know?
Stuff full of goodies.
Yeah.
Well, I found plenty of corn, but fiddleweed is dying out.
Fiddlehead?
Fiddlehead, yeah.
The fiddleweed, because that's no fiddleweed, that's why it died off. I love fiddleheads. It's actually good in salad.
Oh, there are some over there. Let's see if I can get across.
Oh, I can actually just go down from here. The worst, they have to do something about this stair design bullshit.
I know.
Number one priority is wagons.
I actually had a rant. Did I have the rant in one of my videos about the stairs, and I demonstrated how awful they are.
Yeah, that is.
It is a travesty.
It is not funny. I'm not enjoying it at all, Dez. I want my free money, my free. Well,
I want my free $40 back.
Yeah.
And my four copies.
My four copies. No, I actually, honestly, you know, if I think that would, I'm 100% sure I would. This is the kind of game I would continue playing, even off camera.
It's easier off camera.
Yeah.
It's really like I did my solo two videos. It is almost impossible to talk through this grind by yourself.
Oh, yeah.
No, so hard.
Yeah. Put on Eric Carmen.
Wait till you see mine. I'm just rambling about all kinds of shit.
Yeah, I'm just gonna start talking about other subjects. I was telling Pam earlier. It reminds me of Life is Futile. Not quite as bad though. Not as bad. I'm not saying it's as bad, but man, like
that grind was
that was
rough.
Real.
All right, I found more fiddleheads, so now I'm coming home with a full. But that may be all our fiddlehead for a while, because it's all pretty much dying out.
You ever farmed a friggin' fiddleheads? Now we have none left, guys.
Well, they should get the farm going, Mr. Farming, Farmy McFarmerson.
Oh, I hear a little jealousy. Somebody's a little sensitive about their farm.
I want to see that farm.
Someone touched his farm, boo boo.
Touch me on my farm, no.
It is farming place.
That sounds really wrong.
Showing a doll where they touched
you. I just wanted to be known. Game had started.
He's showing a doll where they touched you. Oh my god.
Oh, geez.
That's like a million times worse than I thought you could. Oh my god.
I'm making an abomination of a building, so I'm gonna have to see how this works out. But it's looking quite awful.
You think if I hollowed out the center of the planet, we'd have less gravity?
Oh, I like the new sign game, Ed.
That's an intriguing question.
I think I'm gonna try that.
You should.
And you guys are gonna watch every bit of it on KG for a YouTube channel, or not?
Welcome to KG48's only channel.
They'll just fast forward to the last episode that says world destruction.
So, are we good with only doing three of these a week now, or are we going to start? I was talking to everyone earlier about maybe starting. We're already on different episodes. Should we just start doing what we can and don't worry about the episode number? It would really free us up. It would confuse the listeners for the first couple weeks we do it, but I think they'll because like all the big YouTubers they don't all stay on the same number from what I understand. So
I keep going back to what Minecraft used to do when they were doing videos on the same server.
Yeah,
and they didn't care. The only time that they synchronized episodes was when they were doing like their ultra hardcore events.
Okay.
So maybe we need to do something like when we enable multiplayer. We make them somewhat similar titles or something, but at that point, whatever works for everybody else.
When the asteroid comes to the Earth, we all have to get back together.
Yeah. I think, well, 7 Days to Die, we should definitely all be together at all times. I think that should stay the same because the server's only up when we're playing, and that works. Plus the 7-day hordes and stuff, it wouldn't work.
I think 7 Days to Die in general is just better as a group.
Yeah. But I think this game, and I think Age of Conan, I think we should just maybe dedicate a couple videos a week and, just do our own thing after that.
Works for me.
Age of Conan's not going to work for me if we're not going to play together. I won't even buy it. I'll let you guys do it. Well, that's not a game I'm going to be able to do anything in by myself.
Well, Well, you don't have to. That's the thing. It's up to you to make videos whenever you want. So you don't have to. So you can just record us when we're around. That'd be fine.
I'd say let's take a look at it first. I don't know. I mean, it may be something that works for us. It may not, though. We haven't really gotten our hands on the game and gotten our teeth into it yet.
Unless it's... I can't imagine it's any more reliant on other players than this. I mean, this... You know, if you guys weren't playing, I'd starve to death. You know? So...
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you right now, when Age of Conan comes out, I'm doing daily videos. Unless it's just awful. But I don't think it's going to be awful. I've been watching some streams of it. Looks pretty cool. Unless they don't care about PvE.
How can you watch streams of it? It's not out yet.
No, they've been streaming it.
They stream themselves.
Oh, they're streaming them themselves.
Yeah. They show what they want to show you.
Yeah, I mean, who knows? It could suck, but...
That's the whole thing.
From what they've said and everything I've heard, it sounds like it's going to be pretty cool. And if they respect PvE and it has real PvE, I'll be all over it. If it's a PvP, you know, Rust fest, nothing against Rust, but, you know, I won't be playing it.
Well, it depends.
It's going to be more like Ark, I think.
Yeah, I'm no problem with that. I like Ark.
I think it'll be a combination between Ark and Rust. I think they're going to try to even out both worlds. One thing that I did notice is that they do talk about PvE and calling it out for people that do enjoy PvE. So they are putting effort into it.
That was the first thing I read about them. They said that they're going to have AI. I saw AI. And, you know, they said PvE co-op. Like, so that's what I'm interested in. If the co-op is not real, if it's like Rust co-op, you know, where it's just a couple lame-ass bears that aren't going to do anything, then I'll be done with it. But, you know, I mean, if it's like Ark, I mean, I really liked Ark. I'm going to go back to Ark someday, too. So
I'll tell you what. I mean, if you guys want to throw an Ark server up, they just have a new
We
Pokemon
have an Ark server
out.
Up. We have an Ark server up.
That's another game people have been asking me about. Honestly, yeah, guys, I just don't have time for Ark. And as far as Rust goes, I think we're all in agreement. We don't really have time for Rust at the moment. But Rust is going to make a comeback, I think. I mean, I'm game for it.
Yep.
For
I was
Rust,
enjoying
you know?
It.
Yeah.
Yep. I'm
when
with
I,
you.
When I do play Rust again, I'm going like PvP. Whoever's on my team can build. I'm just going to grab a bow and go shoot people. Like, that's pretty much all I'm going to do, because that's all people seem to want to see me do.
Well, that's cool. So everyone's cool with doing the Pokemon mod on the Ark server then. I didn't hear anyone complain.
Yeah,
that's
what's
awesome.
Up with that? Like,
no.
You know, we should probably talk about that next episode, because this video's been over for a while.
Oh.
All right, take
oh,
us
yeah,
out,
we're
Bish.
Getting up there.
Don't screw up, Bish.
Don't mess it up. Yeah, you already blew it.
Yep, done.
No. Worst episode NA.
Fuck.
Yeah, it's just a pity what I got to work with, unfortunately. But anyway.
Wait, one second. Yeah. Bish,
thank you very much, everyone, for joining us, despite the best efforts of everyone to screw this outro up.
You're gonna blow it.
Anyway, it is goodbye from me. And
note to self.
Any of you guys want to say goodbye?
Note to self. Edit this part out.
Bye bye.
Hey Bish, are you gonna do the outro soon? Because we're getting high on.
Yeah. I already have.
Oh, you goodbye, did? Goodbye. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. I wasn't paying attention, man. I apologize.
No, that's all right.
I'm just giving you a hard time. Much.
All right, guys. See you later.
Good night, everybody.
Catch you guys on flip side.
Bye-bye.
Good night, everybody.
Flip the floor.
There it is.